Hey, what's going on guys, Sandeep here, and sometimes the taskbar won't work on your Windows 11. It may be unresponsive or totally blank, or you don't see the taskbar at all. So in this video, you will see some workaround to fix the taskbar on your Windows 11. So let's start with very basic. If you got this problem for the first time, you need to restart your Windows 11. Press Alt F4 key on your keyboard and try to restart, and check if the taskbar is working or not. And if restarting the PC doesn't work, then try to check the taskbar behavior. Press Windows plus I key together on your keyboard to open the settings app, and then go to personalization and go to taskbar. Click on taskbar behavior and make sure the auto hide taskbar is unchecked. And if you have moved the taskbar icons to the left, then try to move them back into the center as default. And after that, check if you are getting your taskbar or not. If not, follow the next method. For this method, we are going to restart Windows Explorer. For that, you have to open Task Manager first. You can open Task Manager three ways. Press Windows plus R key together on your keyboard and type there Task MGR, and then press OK and it will open the Task Manager. Or you can press the Control Shift and Escape key together to open the Task Manager. Or you can press the Ctrl Alt Delete and then open Task Manager. So anyhow, you have to open Task Manager and then find Windows Explorer process. Select the Windows Explorer and then click on Restart Task. Restarting the Windows Explorer might fix this problem. So you have to restart Windows Explorer first and check if the taskbar is working or not. If not, you can try to terminate some processes using the Task Manager. Open the Task Manager again and then click on this hamburger menu and then go to the Details tab. Now you have to find certain Windows processes and terminate them one by one. So the first process you need to find is runtimebroker.exe. Scroll down and find the runtimebroker.exe, right click on it and then End Process, or click on End Process Tray. So you have to terminate all the processes related to runtimebroker.exe, and don't worry if the process restarts itself. The next process you need to terminate is searchhost.exe and then searchindexer.exe and cellexperiencehost.exe. So you have to terminate these processes using the Task Manager. Now check if the taskbar is working fine or not. If it is not working, then follow the next method. For this method, we are going to re-register the universal Windows platform, or you can say all the default apps. Press Windows plus S key together on your keyboard to open the search and then search for PowerShell and run it as administrator. If you can't open the search, you have to open the Task Manager first. Press the Ctrl Shift Escape key together to open the Task Manager first and click on Run New Task. And type there powershell.exe and check this box, create the task with admin privilege, and click on OK and it will open the PowerShell. Now you have to copy and paste this command from video description and press Enter. And this command will re-register all the Windows apps on your Windows 11. So you have to wait till the process is complete. And you can ignore all the errors during the process. Let the process finish and then exit out PowerShell and restart your Windows 11 and check if the taskbar is working or not. In most cases, this should fix the taskbar problem. If not, follow the next method. For this method, we are going to find and repair any possible corrupt file on our Windows 11. Open the Task Manager first and run new task. Type cmd and create this task as admin. Now you will get command prompt. Type sfc then space forward slash scan now, then press enter on your keyboard. Now the system file checker will try to find any possible corruption with your Windows, and if it finds any kind of corrupt file, it will repair them using the image file on your Windows 11. Now sometimes what happens is that the image file inside your Windows 11 is already corrupt, so you can't run the sfc command. So you have to repair the image file first using these commands, these DISM commands. It will repair only the image file, and after that you have to run the sfc command again. So try to run the system file checker command first, and if it can fix the problem, that's good. If the image file is already corrupt, you have to repair the image file first using DISM commands and then run the SFC command again. And after that, you have to restart your PC and check if the taskbar is working fine or not. And if these methods are not working, then follow the next method. For this method, you can try to uninstall the recent Windows updates and then update your Windows 11. Press Windows plus R key together on your keyboard to open the run dialog box and then type appwiz.cpl and click on OK. Now click on View installed updates and then you can see the recent Windows updates. So you have to find the recent updates by looking at the installation date. And then uninstall the recent Windows updates. After uninstalling the updates, you have to restart your PC and check if the taskbar is working fine or not. If not, you can try to update the Windows 11 itself. So again, press Windows plus I key together on your keyboard to open the Settings app and then click on Windows Update. Now check for the available updates, and if there are new updates available, you have to download and install all those updates. And after that, restart your Windows 11 and check if the taskbar is working or not. If not, follow the next method. For this method, we are going to delete IrisService registry key from the registry editor. So open the task manager first and run new task and type there regedit and click on OK so that you can open registry editor. Click on the yes option, you will get on the screen. And now you have to navigate to this path: HKEY current user, software, then Microsoft, then Windows. Here it is. And then current version. Now look for IrisService registry key. So here it is. Before we delete this IrisService registry key, we need to create a backup first. Right click on it and then export. Select a location where you want to save this backup file, and you can name this backup anything you want. And then click on save. Now just right click on this IrisService registry key and then delete. Click on yes to confirm and then restart your Windows 11 and check if the taskbar is working fine or not. If it is working fine, then great. And if it is still not working, then the registry key didn't create any problem. You can patch that registry key again. So find that registry key and double click on it. Click on the yes option, you will get on the screen, and then yes to continue. So if the registry key is not a problem, you can patch it again. Now if these things are not working, you can try to restore your computer to previous date using system restore. Press Windows plus R key together on your keyboard and type there restrui.exe and click on OK. It will open system restore. Click on next. And then you will find different dates related to system restore. If you don't have any restore point, you can exit out. But if you have any restore point when everything was working fine, select that restore point and click on next and then finish. Click on yes to continue the system restore. Since I am recording, I won't do system restore, but you have to perform the system restore. And after that, it will restart your PC and check if the taskbar is working fine or not. And these methods should help you to fix the taskbar on your Windows 11. If not, you can try to create a new user account or enable the hidden admin account and check if the taskbar is working there or not. If the taskbar is working fine in a new user account, then the current user account is affected. You have to troubleshoot the current user account, or you can create a new user account and move your files there. And I hope this video helped. And two of you who are still here, thanks for watching. Hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Also press the bell icon to get notified about new videos, and I will see you in my next video.